All right, here's a question. What kind of shoes do you wear? Believe it or not, your footwear says a lot about the confidence levels in your relationship. That's according to a new study. People who wore drab new shoes were perceived as insecure about their relationships with other people. In contrast, bright, well-worn shoes signal confidence, confidence about relationships. I want you to listen to what some people said when we interviewed them.
The shoes kind of define the person, kind of the personality.
I am an older woman, so, you know, you would not know looking at my feet.
I think a lot of my shoes are very colorful. And most of yours are very
plain. That means I'm not confident. I take comfortable over confident.
Oof. Okay. Well, I'm not sure about those last ones. Psychologist Wendy Walsh joins me again. So, Wendy, what does this study really tell us about our shoes and our relationships, if anything? Is this true? Can we go by this?
Well, with 90% accuracy, apparently. This is fascinating study out of, by Omri Gilat out of the University of Kansas. And what they were able to do is, so picture this. They took a bunch of people and said, like a few hundred, send in a picture of your most frequently worn shoes. Then separately, they brought them in and put them through a battery of tests to determine their personality traits, etc. Then they had a whole nother group who didn't know them, didn't see them, just looked at pictures of the shoes and took guesses about their personality. And boom, 90% accuracy. Because what we've evolved to have is we need a slice of life very quickly to judge whether somebody's friend, foe, is liberal, conservative, is like us, is not like us, is safe or not. And so we are able very quickly to pick up simple schema and make judgments. And humans are pretty accurate. So, relationships. Drab shoes, but clean, tidy drab shoes, indicate relationship anxiety, meaning worry my partner might leave me. I don't want to really express myself in a big way. It's sort of, it's a safe way to go.
Yeah.
Maybe people who are more comfortable to be able to be themselves are more confident with their relationships and wearing those bright colors.
Oh, interesting. Because people will see shoes and say, I saw that shoe and I immediately thought of you. But before we go there, though, why shoes and not some other clothing?
Well, because Professor Gilat did the study on shoes. No, the truth is most studies that have been done on this simple schema are what they call moving part studies. You're able to sort of see people moving, talking, and gesturing and trying to figure out what their accent says about them or their hair or whatever. This is an inanimate kind of object. This is just a picture of shoes. Could you really tell about somebody's personality just by one simple, stable thing? And it was shockingly accurate. About speed dating. Think how accurate speed dating could be now.
Well, that's like, what is it, Malcolm Gladwell, when he calls a tipping point, or like right away when you know something really quickly.
Blink.
So just because people wore brightly colored shoes, it didn't necessarily mean that they were extroverts.
That was a very interesting finding, is that many people assume that bright colors mean you're this extrovert or wild, outlandish shoes. But it could be that you're just exercising your inner self. You could still be an introvert. I found the most interesting part of the study is that if you tended to wear high tops or combat boots, specific to environment, around the streets, not when you're hiking or in the army, you tend to be less agreeable, a personality that's less agreeable. And I think about my 9-year-old that's a little bit that way sometimes, and she loves those Converse that go right up to the knees.